Why do you think marine mammals gave up on herbivory? On land, it's common for large mammals to be vegetarians, to be herbivores. Elephants, rhinos, hippo, giraffe. But in the sea, it all changed. The large vertebrate animals are carnivores. In fact, there are very few marine mammals that are herbivores, only four species, and they're all relatives, the sirenians, so dugongs, like I've got here, and manatees. Not only are they a rarity in the sea, the vegetarian sirenians are not giants. In fact, they're on the smaller side for a marine mammal. So why is being a herbivore so rare for a large marine animal? It's a matter of resources and how to obtain them. Where on land there's lots of plant material, things like grasses, leaves, fruits and nuts. But plants need sunlight to produce food via photosynthesis, and most of the ocean is deep, really deep. But that's fine for phytoplankton as they drift and live in the light-filled upper water column. But most plant-like material in the ocean is phytoplankton. But only tiny herbivores can live by feeding on phytoplankton. And seagrasses and algae are the other types of marine plants. And they're a decent size, so large enough for larger animals to feed on. But seagrasses and many large algae need to be rooted to a substrate, so they need to grow in shallow waters. But as most of the oceans are deep, there's few habitat for seagrasses and macroalgae to grow. You can see here how the dugong has a downturned skull. The mouth's down here, ideal for feeding along the sea floor. They have a flexible and muscular upper lip over here, and they use this to dig out plants. They eat the whole plant, including the roots, which are rich in nutrients. But because they dig up the whole plant, they leave furrows in the seagrass beds. These sandy paths are called feeding trails. After they've dug up the seagrass, they shake it to remove the sand before they eat it. The sand is abrasive and will damage their teeth. While the teeth of the dugong's cousin, the manatee, are ridged and grooved, which is ideal for grinding plant material, the dugongs are not. Now, most land herbivores, like this giraffe or this horse, they have cheek teeth that are flat grinding surfaces with ridged molars, as you can see here. The cellulose in plants is difficult to break down and digest. So having these grinding surfaces means the animals can break down that plant material into smaller pieces with greater surface area to coat with enzymes and microbes that breaks down the plant cellulose so they can absorb it. But notice that the dugong's teeth are small and flat, and they don't have ridged surfaces as you'd expect for a herbivore. In fact, see how their teeth are worn down. This is typical. They have little enamel on the crowns of their cheek teeth. Now, this is completely different to the manatees, which have ridged grinding teeth like the land herbivores. But notice here at the front of the mouth, this broad bony plate. When the mouth is closed, these bony plates on the upper and lower jaw form a grinding surface that they use to break up cellulose of the seagrass. Now, dugongs don't tend to feed in what we would think of as lush seagrass, but rather where the seagrass is sparse. The seagrass species that tend to dominate established seagrass beds grow slowly and are fibrous, whereas the seagrasses that grow quickly, the ones the dugongs like to eat, are low in fibre, so they're easier to break down and digest, and they're also high in nitrogen. And because they grow quickly, they re-establish in those sandy feeding trails left by the dugongs. So the dugong's feeding behaviour produces more of the food they like. This is called cultivation grazing. And by moving between different seagrass beds, the dugongs have a cycle of beds that they visit and are growing at different stages. So while other marine mammals, like whales, dolphins and seals, develop completely new techniques to exploit their new marine environment, like eating fish and schools of krill or amphipods, and they became enormous carnivores, the dugongs and manatees retained a similar feeding strategy as their terrestrial herbivorous ancestors, which was a distant relative of the elephant. And the maximum size of marine herbivores has stayed stable through evolutionary time.